I'm not sure. Sorry, I'm having lots of issues here. Trying to figure this out. Okay, we're live. Have to change the address, but Okay, we're live.
So I don't have any connectors.
Do you want to get this going?
Yeah, it's working. But I had to change the URL. I had to create a new one because the old one wasn't working. Don't know. It's one of those weird things that happen. Like,
Eva Murray. She's Chicago or anywhere else, basically all over the world on social media, and that's about it. Yeah, trymydata.com. Anything else? Am I missing anything?
No.
Okay, that's enough. And she's a co-author of an upcoming book.
This is Andy Cable, and there's probably not many people who don't know Andy in the Timber community. He's got a very popular blog. It's vizwithbi.com. And yeah, that's where you can find him, on Twitter as well. He is a Zen Master, he's been a Zen Master for 5 years. That's why he got inducted into the Hall of Fame. Rightly so. He runs the data school here in London. That's part of the information lab, and there's who is here from the data school or previously at the data school. Yeah, I love that. So these are already or up and coming Tableau stars. So keep an eye out for them. Yeah, okay, I think that's enough introductions. Everyone knows this anyway. What's Makeover Monday? You start.
Okay. So back when we started Makeover Monday as a community project in 2016, I was running it with Andy Cocker. Actually, I was running it myself. He just happened to be visualizing along with me. he's not here either, right? I can't hear when I say that. But it was really interesting because we started just tweeting things out, and we were really worried that the people that used to kind of, I don't want to say own the hashtag, but if you looked on Twitter and searched up Makeover Monday, you'd see things like home repair and what do they say when you get your lips done?
Makeup or Botox?
Botox, yeah, Botox. Eyebrows, hair, all kinds of like, you know, fashion makeovers and things like that. So, but that's not what Makeover Monday is now. So if you search the hashtag now, you see lots and lots of different pictures and charts and things like that. And in 2016, we thought, well, maybe these people that do these makeup makeovers would like to get to know us a bit better. So we had a data set about makeup. So we were doing a makeover about makeup, and no, none of them responded, so it's kind of a fail. But now the hashtag is primarily about data visualization, mostly with Tableau, but we're seeing a lot more influence now from Power BI and Google Data Studio and R. Instagram and Yellowfin and what's the other one?
Excel?
Yeah. What's that? Oh, that's the conference center where Tableau's conference is going to be.
Yes.
Yeah.
31st of July, be there.
Okay. So anyway, let's keep going.
I actually think we are live broadcasting this, right? So maybe we should do a quick shout out to everyone who's watching wherever you are. Send us a tweet.
They must really have nothing better to do.
I guess it's early enough, right? But there's people actually watching online what we're doing, so. Hello, everyone. Okay, so we've kind of made this our tagline, improving how we visualize and analyze data one chart at a time, because that's what we're here to do, and that's what we want to encourage everyone else to do, because there's a lot of bad charts out there, which is really what Makeover Monday is for. And the way it works is that typically on Sunday we publish the data and an article and as well as a visualization on data.world. Not this week, because otherwise you would have to work ahead, come here, and
what are you doing? I was trying to cheat a week ago. 5 days, right?
People publishing their visualizations, or maybe publishing a draft and saying, hey, does this work, or should I change something? Then on Tuesday, it keeps going, but kind of starts slowing down a bit. And on Wednesday, we can this review. Who has participated in this review or listened to it? Okay, a few. So this is a webinar that we run every week on our Bright Talk channel, where you can submit through the data.world discussion forum your visualization to get feedback, because even if you just look at this room, there's a lot of people. We get hundreds of submissions every week, and we can't reply to everyone on Twitter. It's just not possible. So this review is your way to opt into feedback. And then we go through the visualizations one by one and give comprehensive, constructive, and quick feedback as best we can. Sometimes mean. I have to, you know, be the nice one. I think it suits him, doesn't it? And we just try and give some feedback, which is a lot easier when we actually talk through it And that happens on Wednesday. And then people typically iterate and review.
Can I say thank you to Charlie? Where's Charlie? Raise your hand. Charlie has stepped in twice to when I've been out on vacation. So those are my first two ever Makeover Monday vacations. So anyway, thank you, Charlie, for covering.
I just want to say I do this review during my vacation.
Okay. I've done it a year longer than you.
I'm not going to say what I was going to say. Anyway, so people do their stuff and they, you know, change their visualizations, show us what they've done, and then on Fridays we publish the week's recap, so a blog with the lessons from the week. We now have to, for time purposes, limit ourselves to two lessons, so typically one about design, one about analysis, and just show what maybe a number of people struggled with and how to address that. And we also list our favorites, so the visualizations that stood out that week.
And there's also a nice gallery page now on the Makeover Monday website. If you haven't seen it, there's a little link at the top for gallery, and we're putting all of the visits that we talk about and all the favorites are on there. This is a really nice digital gallery if you ever need some inspiration.
Yes, and then comes Saturday, and we prepare the release for the next week. And I have to say, yesterday, Sunday, was the quietest Sunday since starting Monday, because we didn't release the data. There was nothing to do. Actually, enjoyable. And we have the hashtag Makeover Monday, of course. So while we don't do a lot of feedback directly on Twitter, that's still where a lot of the conversation is happening. Okay.
So why should you participate in Makeover Monday? First thing is, it's a great way to practice Tableau or any other tool that you're using. The other way to get really good at something is to do it a lot. If you just watch other people use Tableau, you're not going to get better at Tableau. And one of the great things about it is you can practice with data sets that aren't your data sets you use at work. So your work data gets boring. Who gets bored with their work data? It's okay. Yeah, it gets very, very boring. So this is a really good way to just practice with new data sets. And it's a good way to practice kind of your analytical skills, because you have to think about this data quickly. You have to read maybe a bit about the background and then make some decisions about what you want to do, and you need to do it quickly. So it's a great way to practice data analysis, and then those are things that you can take back into your regular job. So it kind of gives you your brain a bit of a relief from your humdrum daily data. And of course, you get better at visualizations and storytelling.
It also lets you build your profile, and we've been talking about this a lot in the past as well. And hopefully everyone here has a Tableau public profile, or we'll set it up tonight. These are just a couple of screenshots from our profiles. It's not to show always so amazing, but there's a diversity and a variety in those visualizations. And over the course of a year, if you participate every week, you get 52 visualizations in your portfolio. That lets you show people what you do in terms of design, analysis, you know, how deep you go, or do you go broad and you know, more informative, or is it really analytical? And how do you tell data stories, and how do you communicate information? It also shows your progression, and we always tell people, don't delete your old stuff. You're free to look at our profiles to the very bottom, where the first really crappy ones are. Don't delete them, because it shows your progress, and it shows people that you've improved over time. And actually, my dad, the other day, he's not participating, but he commented how Sarah Burnett in Singapore is like, yeah, she's really improved. So people notice, even old people, like my dad.
It's also, so I mentioned this already, but it's a good way to get inspired, not only by your own work and bringing that back into your daily job, but you might see other people's visualizations, and maybe a data set a few weeks down the road, you would say, oh, I really liked what, you know, whoever did that visualization that week, I'm going to try it with this data set. So it's a good way to kind of it's encourage each other, inspire each other, and we're all really in this to help each other in the end. We all want to get better at what we're doing. You won't really find any jerks in the community. They get run out pretty quickly. They haven't run me out, though. Maybe I'm just the king jerk. But anyway, you'll notice a lot of the feedback on here is everybody's very encouraging for each other. You know, when people are giving feedback about visualizations, they're not criticizing the person. They're just giving constructive feedback on the visualization to try to help the person. So when you do give feedback, make it about their work, not about them.
Okay, next one. It lets you write a book. And you have to keep hover until you see the play thingy.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Wait, oh, there it goes.
Oh, there we go. So for those who haven't heard yet, Andy, Monday, and Pat Lowe's design agency has been so kind to design a beautiful cover and a little video to give you a first hint of what this will look like. And we have spoken to the publisher, and it's going to come out on the 16th of October with a big launch at the Tableau conference. And this is the first time we're talking about it, so you guys are the first to hear it, which we're very excited about. We also have a discount code for you. We're waiting for that to actually be able to be applied when you go to Wiley.com, but if you pre-order using that code on their website, you get 35% off. So we just want to put that in there.
You're going to hear a lot of shameless plugs over the next few months, so just get used to it.
I'm just going
to
do this, a book.
Yeah.
And it is my sincere hope that Andy will finish the last chapter very soon.
It's my hope as well.
Yes. Good, I'm glad we have
the best of intentions over the weekend.
We will actually probably talk to a lot of you over the course of the coming days and weeks about the book in various different ways.
I think Pablo from the data school ordered the very first copy.
He ordered it. It's on Amazon as well, and we're quite excited to see our author profile. It's very grown up.
So he ordered it, and then he got an email, and he said, wait, I'm not getting it until October. So anyway, we have to be done by the middle of May, so we've got 3-4 weeks.
You've got to be done, Okay.
It's also a great way to connect with other people. So last year, we did a lot of Makeover Monday live sessions just like this. Quite a few around Europe, in Dublin, and Helsinki, Milan, Amsterdam, Paris, London, Sydney. That London one was at the Tableau conference, so we're doing that again this year. I guess it'll be on Tuesday this year.
Yes.
Right? Okay, so that'll be another week where the date is delayed. And then we also went to Munich, Berlin, Hamburg, Frankfurt, Copenhagen, San Diego, the San Diego Tableau user group. And it all culminated at the Tableau conference in Las Vegas, where 500 of you nerds joined together in one room about an hour ahead of time. Is that about right? Just full about an hour ahead of time, with about 250 or so people waiting outside that couldn't get in that were really mad. So we're hoping for a stadium this year. We'll see if we get to that.
Sounds good. Okay, yeah. Now, the last reason that we give people why they should participate is to make an impact. Who participated last year in September for the Sustainable Development Goals Make a Monday session? Yeah, a few. Okay, so what we did was we collaborated a few times during last year with Chloe from Viz for Social Good and some nonprofits to see, you know, how can we help them crowdsource data stories and good data visualizations. And this was one of my favorite examples because it really had an impact where in the bottom corner you see these visualizations being displayed at the UN General Assembly in New York later that month. So that was really exciting to see. It's not just a little Makeover Monday, it can actually go much further. And with those words, I want to introduce Jeff Benson from PATH. And he's come all this way to present to you, but also to talk about visualized nomenclature. And I'll hand over to you.
Thank you, Ika. Thanks, Andy. It's a pleasure to be here in London. The last time I was in London, I got to present on visualized nomenclature. And it was an hour and 25 minute talk. So I figured that's what you're going to give me now, right? No, this is going to be a quick overview. Jeff Burnson, I work for an organization called PATH. We're a global health organization, and we focus on bold new ideas to help us face some of the greatest public health challenges in the world today. And we work across 5 platforms, vaccines, drugs, diagnostics, devices, and something we call systems and services. Innovations, and that's one of the things we're going to be focused on today. Thank you. So I wanted to talk a little bit about a project that I help run at PATH. If we could just go back for a second. It's called Visualize No Malaria. It's a, next slide, it's a partnership. We had a big chance to practice this ahead of time. It's a partnership between PATH and the Ministry of Health in Zambia and 8 tech companies. If you just press, there you go. And we're all working towards the same goal, if you just advance the slides again, to helping Zambia, a country in southern Africa, advance towards their vision of becoming malaria-free by 2021. And this is an ambitious goal. This is a country of about 16 million people, all who live at risk of getting malaria. And yet, at the same time, this is a country that in the last 10 years has made tremendous strides in terms of eliminating this deadly disease. This is a disease that still kills over about 400,000 people a year. It's still one of the top five killers of children under five. It is something that the world is still paying attention to, but yet we're at a moment in time where we're seeing some of our results start to plateau. And one of the best ways that we can keep our progress towards eliminating malaria going is by making better use of the data that we have available to us. And yet that also, while that's an opportunity, that also is our challenge, because this data that we're gonna be especially looking at today is information that's collected in health facilities and health centers and by community health workers who live and work in communities in countries like Zambia. So if we go to the next slide here, we have made tremendous progress as a project and a partnership, working with the likes of Tableau, Exasol, Alteryx, Datablick, Slalom, Mapbox, Digital Globe, in making better use of data and putting better visualizations in the hands of officials and decision makers at some of the lowest levels in Zambia. Those are people who work at districts and also at health facilities and health clinics. And so the power of this data and creating visualizations that are user-driven is really at the heart of this project. If we go to the next slide. We're making tremendous progress, actually. And some of the data that you're gonna be looking at today is actually the cases, the number of cases that have been monitored or counted, essentially, in one province in Zambia. And you can see over time, since 2014, we've seen a dramatic decrease in the number of cases in southern province in Zambia. And we're showing an area chart. This is kind of a typical visualization that our counterparts in Zambia look to help them make better decisions about where malaria is currently and where it might pop up next. And yet, I think with the help of this group, we can do even better than some of the visualizations that we've produced today. We go to the next slide. And just sort of an added bonus, this is to really follow on to your point about how one of your Makeover Mondays, I think, that worked on the Sustainable Development Goals was then elevated to a higher order, if you will. This week, this meeting, this Makeover Monday, happens to coincide with an event called CHOGM, which is the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting that's happening here this week, where at this meeting there will be a malaria summit where there will be 52 countries that really get behind the goal of basically cutting malaria in half in the Commonwealth countries around the world. And so some of the work that we're doing today in Zambia likely could potentially be elevated across the what we call the Elimination 8 countries. These are surrounding countries, 8 countries surrounding Kenya, I'm sorry, Zambia, that also are looking to eliminate malaria. So my hope is that some of the work that we actually accomplished today will actually turn itself into visualizations that we can use as a project and an initiative that will eventually, hopefully, as early as this later this year, we could see in some of the dashboards that are being used not only in Zambia, but in some of the other countries. So with that, I just want to say thank you. Thanks for your participation today. This is a great effort. I have to say, I have never attended a Makeover Monday, so shame on me. I've used Tableau for, 7 years. I think it's about time that I join the club and start showing off my work and getting really constructive feedback from Andy, of course. So with that, thanks, Eva.
I think one of the interesting things here is, you know, Jeff was saying that some of this stuff might make it into the program this week that they have here. And think about the story. You can tell by some of you creating something in an hour with a data set you've never seen that's able to have an impact, and the story he can then take to the government officials with that. You know, just, we only did this for an hour and look what we're able to accomplish. So hopefully that gives you a bit of drive for what you're about to embark on.
Yeah. So I'll be sticking around for the rest of the time if people have questions. I'm happy to talk further about it. Thanks.
Thank you, Jeff. So I hope that gets you guys excited. We're not looking at some, you know, penny little data set. This is going to be actually something fun and interesting. A quick disclaimer, you will see it in the data. This is simulated data, not the actual cases, because that's, you know, sensitive information that we couldn't just turn around and say to the Zambia Ministry of Health, oh, we're just going to use your data. So it is realistic, the trends are the same, it's just not the actual numbers. So how to participate in Makeover Monday? A small slide with 7 steps. Basically, the recommendation is check out the original visualization, and we will put it up on the screen as that yellow and orange area chart. Read the accompanying article for context. So this time we don't really have a news article as such, but on data.world you will find information below the chart that tells you what the different spikes are and where to find more background information around, you know, the project, etc. Then analyze and visualize the data in the tool of your choice, which I'm assuming, given where you are, you will all be using Tableau. And as you go about it, ask your neighbors, ask other people, but also ask us for help if you get stuck in any way.
There might be people online that are not Tableau users.
There might be. I just mean for the people in the room. Then publish your visualization. So we've given you all the options there, but please don't hesitate. Do publish it online for others to then see, and share it with the Makeover Monday community. So on data.world, there are discussion forums where we ask people to post their visualizations, because it's much easier for us to keep track of than Twitter. But also, if you feel like it, and if you have a Twitter account, share it on Twitter, because that gives you a much broader reach if you want to build your own profile, your personal brand. There's a couple of things that are helpful to include an image, because on a mobile phone, that's much easier to see. If you just do the type of public link, there is no real preview. Tag us so that it's in our notifications, and add the hashtag Makeover Monday.